While we wait for the celebrations in Parc Fermé, here's the final classification. Well, it's a shame he didn't make it to the podium today, but he's...
You know, the tyre wear on this game, it just does you in. Right. I was in fifth for the first couple of laps of that race. I was cruising, they couldn't keep up with me, but because you've got to go so steady round all the corners, because the tyre wear is just so bad. It's so bad. Like, that's only seven laps. Imagine if you were doing a full fucking, I mean, how many? 100% of the race. That's just ridiculous. If I was doing 100% of the laps, I wouldn't even... My tyres would be gone after fucking... Not even seven laps. So I'd have to do the four... I'd end up in last place every race. Through no fault of my own. I mean, it's not like I absolutely ragged the bike either. I wait for it to sit up on the exit of corners. You know, I don't hammer the fucking throttle coming out of corners till the bike's sat up. And even then, I ease it on so the tyres aren't spinning out. It's just like, I don't know what I need to do to make the tyres not fucking wear out instantly. I mean, that was in the wet as well. I mean, wet tyres should last a full race, like they do in an actual GP. Because it's not like you can choose the hard or the soft, or they didn't have any of that in this one, did they? So you don't have a choice. Like, whereas the normal races in the dry, I can just choose the hard tyre. Maybe not go as fast, but I can, like, it'll prolong the race, the life of the tyre through the race. It's a fucking nightmare. Like every race in this game so far on simulation,
hello,
I've been right up there till the last couple of laps, and then my tyres have just spat me off every time. There's just, like, nothing you can do. I mean, I couldn't be taking it any steadier if I tried. I could not. There's just nothing I could do to make this bike be better. I mean, it's alright using soft in qualifying, because you don't use them long enough. So you can get a fast time down, but... Even the ads, they just rip them up after seven laps. And it's not like you can use a hard rear and a hard front and a soft rear, because the front gets chewed up just as much as the back. But the back tyre shouldn't get chewed up as much, because they mainly use the front brake, don't they? Maybe it's because I've got joint braking on, maybe. Maybe because it's doing both of them all the time. Maybe it'll do it. But I did just have a thought, maybe if you upgrade the chassis and the suspension, maybe that improves the tyre wear as well. Or maybe it's because I'm with a shit manufacturer, like, I mean, Aprilia are one of the worst ones, right? So maybe that's it. Maybe the better bikes have better tyre wear. I mean, they're the same tyres, aren't they, but the bikes will be smoother. In real life, that'd be the fact, wouldn't it? Maybe not in the MotoGP world. I hope the new one, I hope it in VR46.2. I hope it's MotoGP 17. Because that game was fucking awful. Couldn't be arsed doing all that shit in between races. It's fucking like a race. And they took all the garage out. They, like, took everything good out of it, this game. And put loads of shit in it. Worse. Like, why would you take the garage out of a racing game? Like, for me, MotoGP should be more like F1, you know? Like, I'm pretty sure on F1, you get, like, interviews and stuff, like, it'd add a bit to the game. This track doesn't seem to be chewing through the tyres as much, but I think you get 8 laps on here instead of 7. That's got to be enough, that has to be enough. What does that fuck up in this section? Like that. Yeah, so something else I've realised on this game as well, even if you don't use, like, I don't use manual gears, but, like, say you're going wide in a corner, if you knock it down a gear, it does pull you round, even though you aren't using gears. That should be it. Yeehaw. Yeah, that VR46, I just uninstalled it, and I mean, the car racing in that is fucking atrocious. The cars, it's like they've got, like, a brick. It's like trying to fucking turn a brick. Right, and you've got to drift around all these cones and that, and it's, oh my god, I swear PS1 driving was better than that.
We're back live.
I mean, the dirt bike races are alright the first time you do them. Like, you think, oh yeah, it's pretty cool. And then, after you've done them a couple of times, you're like, oh, for fuck's sake, I've got to do this shit again. Just takes so long in between races. I mean, I like the little Twitter feed thing they've added into that, but what I don't like is they've took all this bit out. All the garage has been taken out. You know, fuck. I've skipped it too much, a lot of talking. Fuck.
Let's have a look at the times after the second
awesome.
And final.
What a bastard. Yeah, I think, like, the Twitter thing were pretty cool, but, like, why take the garage out? They should have built on the garage. The garage was a good thing to have in the game. They should have built on it.
Hello and welcome.
And, like, doing post-race interviews and stuff, you know, and, like, adding a little cinematic, you know, when you win the race, like, they do the cinematic where they all three riders park the bikes in, but they don't do the cinematic of them, you know, like, going on the podium. Just little things like that just add to the game. Like, this game's just a rinse and repeat of 14, just with different liveries on it. It's never really improved. That was 7 laps. It's on real late today, isn't it, MotoGP? Fucking does my head in it. The first one at Qatar, when they did all the bloody... None of the races started on time at that, did they? So my BT Sport recorded like an hour of fucking interviews and stuff, and then didn't record the race. Oh, I was so pissed off. Like Sky, if you're recording something and it goes on a bit extra, it carries on recording it, doesn't it? But BT box done for some fucked up reason. This has got to be one of the easiest going tracks on your tyres I've been on. It's barely even used any. Usually on any normal track that'd be a quarter gone by now. It's because they're all nice easy corners, like you don't have to brake really. Fuck, I braked well there then. Fuck me. A lucky boy then. I just love it when they bring out a new GP game, having all new bikes. Like this one, I couldn't wait to buy it just to get the Suzuki. I think with the next one, they need to do all the stuff what I've just fucking added onto it, and then they need to make different riders win as well, because it gets boring, fucking same rider winning every fucking race. But in the end, I just end up fucking knocking some of them off, you know, just to make it interesting. I mean, you look at MotoGP this year, you've had like Carol Abraham finishing like second, you know, fucking never had happened on this, never. Like, Aprilia never score points, ever. Same with the Minstrel in Moto2, that never scores points, neither does the Octo. Can't fucking get past these. Shit. Oh, done it, boys. You fucking like that braking, didn't you? Yeah, I might actually score good points for fucking first time. I've only got 18 points out of first three or four. It's hard on simulation, right? Like. I'm just going to have to follow him around for a couple of laps, because I'm going to end up killing Sire. It was fine for the first two laps, and now that I've overtook a few, it's fucking on well now. As soon as they start flashing, that's it. As soon as you try putting the accelerator on out of corners, that's it. The bike's fucking wobbling, you can't get the power down. And I think I went from 7th to fucking 14th in a lap and a half in that last race. just not worth ragging it just to stay ahead of him for a little while. So if he's got his slow as fuck, might as well, eh? Never get that corner perfect, ever. I always just, like, spoon it every turn. Oh shit, look at that fucking tyre. I'm fucking rewinding, I don't give a flying fuck. Oh man, I looked at the tyre for 1 second. Imagine how hard it is on fucking little windy tracks. I mean, the tyre's nearly dead now. After six laps. I've got another 2 laps to do. That's going to be flashing at the end of this lap. And then as soon as that happens, I mean, it'll be alright on this track because it's not as windy, like the corners are real open. It's just when I'm getting the power down out the corners, I'm never going to tip these two. With that tyre, and that's the thing what makes it so hard on simulation, the tyre wear on, because you've got to fucking judge when you can use the tyre or not. So it does make it good, but it makes it annoying as well that you can. I mean, I could never have it on more laps than what I've got it on now, because I've never been able to keep the tyre unless they've made it so it lasts longer the more. I mean, maybe that's degrading as if this is an actual full race, whereas if it's a full race, it would degrade as it is. Like, I don't know how to explain what I'm saying, but I know what I'm saying. Like, it degrades it degrades slower if you get the full amount of laps, is what I'm trying to say. But at the same speed as what it does on this. Yeah, there we go, look. Fucking called it, you know. Right as I get right up to them. Bullshit. Still got a little bit on them. I'll have a sneaky look. Should tap him on this corner. I can't believe I've still got grip. There's no fucking thing's not even moving. I didn't just do the chassis then, I mean, I don't know. Oh man, sorry Rossi. Sorry about that one. Yeah, fuck off Jorge. Alright, I'll get you on this corner lap. Oh, might actually fucking win a race. I can't believe these tyres have lasted all that time. I've still got a bit of grip. Win, and I got the trophy as if I've never won there. Back from Italy, what the it's the Aprilia trophy. Win a race with an Aprilia team. Any game mode. Awesome.
He deserves these celebrations with his mechanics cheering him on. He dictated the rhythm of the race. No one could keep up with his seriously impressive pace.